Hello, in this video I will talk a little bit about card handling and how this is handled in the eRe Health solution. So what you can currently see here, these are the typical components of the telematic infrastructure. You see a connector and you see a card terminal, and there are currently two cards. So the card which is on the card terminal, it's a test electronic doctor ID, in German called EHBA, Elektronischer Heilberufsausweis. And what you can also see here is there is an organizational card, so a card that issues the identity of the organization. In this particular case, this is a hospital and it's the Vincent Krankenhaus. And you can see a card terminal. And a card terminal, you can put up to four cards into the card terminal. So two small ones and two big ones. The small ones are the compounding parts here. So if you break out this part, you can put it in the card terminal. And here's also an image how you can put the two big cards into the card terminal. And then you do an information model on the connector. And afterwards, there is a function called getCards. And if you call this function getCards, the connector will tell you all the cards that are currently in some of the slots. So let's run this getCard function. And I have this infrastructure here at home. So therefore, I can just do all this stuff and test all this stuff. And now if we take this here, and if we beautify this, beautify XML, and let's make this a little bit bigger. So now I can show you all the cards that are currently there. So what you can see here is that the first card, I have an EHBA, an HBA, and this HBA, it's from Marianne Oldenburg, test only. And then I have a SMCB. And the SMCB is the one from the Vincent Krankenhaus. And there's also a SMCKT. So the SMCKT, it's a card for the card terminal itself. So this makes it possible that the card terminal can take part at the telematic infrastructure. And this small card is different between the productive environment and the reference environment. So currently in my card terminal there is an SMCKT for the reference environment. So the important thing, so let me show you a diagram about that. So what is on these cards? So these cards, they contain certificates. And let me just go in here. And then I'm going to show a little bit about these certificates. So the EHBA, they both cards can contain multiple certificates. So for different kinds of applications like authentication or signing, there are different certificates on these cards and also key pairs. And that's important because one mistake that I made in the past is that I used the wrong card for the wrong usage. In this particular case, I used the authentication certificate of the EHBA and tried to figure out why the certified authority from the authentication certificate is different compared to the signature. And the reason why this mistake was there is because I didn't realize that these EHBAs can have multiple certificates. But also for the SMCB, it can have multiple certificates. They are just normally used, and they are on the cards, and they are also secured by pins. So when you want to use these different things for doing something, like for authentication or for signing, you have to enter a pin to load these certificates. Then our system by default searches for the first SMCB and uses the first SMCB. One important thing is if you want to use an SMCB, you have to activate it. So normally the typical workflow is that the first every morning when the doctor comes to the practice, he unlocks the SMCB, and then the SMCB can use over the whole day. That's important for the SMCB. We are from eRe.health, just searching the first SMCB, and then we are just using it. And we need it for the BIRA token. So I can just show you this in the code. So we have this BIRA token service. And the Bira token service needs the X509 certificate from the SMCB. And the next thing what we need is we sign the normal documents, and there we use the first EHBR that we find, unless you specify some runtime configuration. So, and I will just show you this runtime configuration as an example. So there is this WebSocket messages, and in the WebSocket messages we have lots of examples. And here there is a sign that uploads bundles with runtime config. And here we are providing runtime configuration. So in this particular case, we are handing in an EHBR handle and an SMCB handle. So this will be the two cards that will be used for signing and getting a Bira token. And this is the configuration of the connector. And in this particular case, there's also a certificate given here that has to be used to talk to this connector. So this was about card handling. Also from the general know-how, it's very important that you know how these cards work, how when you have to unlock something, and also the activation process of these EHBRs, it's quite complex. So I would just sketch it. So first what you do is you go to one of the websites of a trust center. Then as a doctor, you register for some of these cards. Then these trust centers, they will check with your local KV that you're a real doctor. Then it takes typically 1 week to up to 3 months. Then they send you the card. The card has transports pin on it. So you have to change the transport pin for the normal authentication, and you have to change the transport pin for the normal QES signature. And then after doing this, you also have to activate the card. And if you have all done this, afterwards you can use the card for QES, so for qualified signatures. And this activation process, it's time consuming and a little bit complex. So I would recommend that you as a software provider provide good support for this process, and that you help all the doctors to get their doctor ID in German EHBR. Thanks a lot and bye bye.